Oh man, you guys, I woke up with a headache, like a sinus headache. Jeez. Gonna eat my soup and my leftover fish and everything, and yeah. Once I feel better, I'm gonna go to Walgreens and get another hand sanitizer bottle because I'm running low. See this? And yeah, made more of my favorite chips. Garden. Not the garden, the where did it go? The natured still nibbling on these. That's what it looks like out there right now. Okay. Yeah. Excuse me. Videos today too. That's clam chowder, and I'm gonna put crackers on there.
Too. It is a large company.
Don't
errors are made. Good day, Mr. DuBois.
Bridget wants to know if we can contribute a little something to Mr. Reshmi's engagement ring fund. You gotta hand it to the girl. She's really built a bridge between the DuBois family and its creditors.
Thank you. first thing in the morning.
It looked like it rained, or it was gonna rain or something. But right now I am going to go to the gas station this way down, just across the street from me. I want to get some coffee, so I'll catch you later, okay?
Myself yesterday. Somebody's turned it up.
Who? I mean, the thermostat could just be broken.
No, it looks like more than that.
The same might have just come loose.
Washington, D.C. That's all. And when you get there, I'll be waiting. You're gonna make a whole lot of money, and I'm gonna give you everything.
We need to talk about that. It really doesn't work that way. Because frankly, if it did, I would have known we would have this awkward moment and I would have told you years ago. And I'm really sorry I didn't.
It's okay. I'm not sure what I would have made of it all those years ago. I guess things happen for a reason.
No, I guess. Oh, if you need anything, you know we're right across the hall.
Medium.
Alrighty.
A dentist would have to place the right kind of fillings and crowns. Seems like a lot of work. I don't know why anyone would do that.
What if I told you that with Graham Stacey in prison, Mary Stacey's $7 million life insurance policy would go to a charity called the Deerbrook Foundation?
The what? Your Honor, counsel is turning this hearing into
a foundation that happened to be headed up by a local dentist by the name of Dr. Leo Crane. A man we believe colluded with Mary Stacey to fake her own death, frame my client,
so that she could cash in her own life insurance policy.
Your Honor, this
Your
is
Honor,
ridiculous.
Your Honor, we believe that the woman who died in that house fire...
Cynthia? It's Allison.
Hey, Allison. I'm on my way to the hospital. Melanie's about to give her statement to the police. Both girls are a bit shaken up, but they're doing fine.
Cynthia,
to your next young lover. You're still at the last. So now that you got him where you want him, the trick is to move in for the kill. See, that's what really separates the Cougars from the Pussycats.
I want to do it again.
That's nice.
Like it?
Oh, yeah. That feels good.
Like
it? You notice that they no one there really fits that description.
I saw her as plain as day.
That's the thing, Allison. Whoever did this, there's nothing womanly about her. It's pretty savage, bordering on butchery. It's hard to imagine a woman of any age with the anger, not to mention the strength necessary to hack this fellow. Come in.
Oh, sorry, Lee.
Hey, come on in, Allison. Do you remember Ben, my campaign manager, Ben Salzberg, Allison Dubois?
Hey, Ben. Davalos, an instinct for justice. Well, you have my vote, Mr. Davalos.
There's one.
Yeah, I didn't care to show you the sun because there wasn't hardly any showing of it. It looked like it was gonna rain all day, so yeah. I spent around $15 today at the gas station. I forgot to share that with you. And soon I'm gonna go to bed, so Mom, you know the rules. No banging things, like make a noise. Hug and kiss Patty if you're bored. No touching things. Only Patty you can touch. I'll have Piglet during the night hours, and you can have him during the day hours. Tomorrow I go to therapy, so I gotta leave here at noon, so, or maybe earlier if I want to grab a bite to eat or something like that at that sandwich shop. So that's what it looks like down there. Lights are on. Yeah, I'm gonna play bingo now and maybe another pool game or something. And yeah, so nothing more going on here.
Don't worry, I'll be sending a hot young man in a minute. Richard, come on in, take a seat. I'll just leave and let you two catch up. So you. What are you talking about, man? I got a message to come see you.
I can see right now. On this particular day, Tigger and Eeyore were busy with a plan to capture a mysterious creature called the Vaxxon, when Tigger had the idea that having two of him would be far better than just one. Whew, buddy. If you're gonna pounce, you got to have some bounce.
We just need to get you Tiggerized.
Gonna fix you up. By the time we're through, I'll be Tigger 1, you'll be Tigger 2. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. Gonna be two pals hunting in the woods. And they showed at bets and we got the goods. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great.
E3.
I guess
you're the way placenta tastes. I-20. O-68. G-54. N-33. O-62. Round over.
Someone in the chat had said they didn't actually...
Plugged you in, you were at 23% anyway, so I'm gonna get ready for bed now. So yeah. I'm gonna take my pills, brush my teeth, take a gas X because that veggies and grains gave me gas. And I will see you in the next video. Again, mommy, no make a noise. Well, I'm all ready for bed, sort of. All I have to do is, you know, strip down and get naked. I keep my lower underwear on, not the top underwear like this, my bra. But yeah, I'm all done with taking my pills and brushing my teeth. I feel like I got a burp. And I took my IV guard, not gas X, because I read the box and it says it takes care of gas too. So I don't need to take the gas X. And I'm thinking I should take Tylenol just in case, you know, if I have aches and pains in bed for some odd reason, which would be weird, but yeah. Better safe than sorry. So again, if my scheduled app doesn't record, then good night now. It didn't record at 11:45 last night. It gave me a playback error and there was no thumbnail like I showed you a couple of weeks ago. So yeah, okay. Good night now.
Over her when he found her body, because he did not want anyone else to see her the way that he had found her. The detectives believed that the family had been killed elsewhere in the apartment and then moved to the areas that they were found after. Autopsies were done of the mother and her sons. Yvonne's autopsy indicated that she had been SA'd by a mop handle. She was also stabbed 60 times in the upper chest and abdomen. She was then strangled. Carlos, the older boy, was struck 6 times in the head with a barbell. He had died of multiple skull fractures.
He also had been stabbed. Police, struggling to find any sort of motive, could only come up with one possible negative interaction between the two. Kylan, apparently, had once asked Adam to leave her alone when she came into the kitchen to grab some food. This was something that angered him greatly, and he went on to complain to the manager. He then went on to complain to other co-workers that she was getting food while she wasn't even scheduled, something that he found immoral. Given that they didn't even work the same shift and that everyone was wearing masks during COVID, it's believed that Kylan didn't even recognize Adam or know who he was at the time. To her, this was just some strange man who was chewing her out while she was grabbing some food. One even more confusing.
Ronnie was making his way home. His route required him to pass through an underpass beneath a busy North Circular Road. Despite the hour and the cold, he was taken aback to see a group of 5 children down there collecting pennies in preparation for Guy Fawkes Night. It was peculiar considering the eldest girl looked no older than 12, with the rest being even younger. What truly startled Ronnie, though, was their attire. Their clothes seemed to have been plucked straight from the 1920s or 30s. Their manner of speech was reminiscent of characters from a Charles Dickens novel. Overhearing one of the boys, he said, "The other gen..."